I have often puzzled and puzzled about what it must be like to go to sleep and never wake up, to be simply not there forever and ever. After all, one has some intimation of this by the interval that separates going to sleep from waking. When we don't have any dreams but go to sleep, and then suddenly we're there again, and in the interim there was nothing. And if there was never any end to that interval, if the waking up didn't happen, that's such a curious thought. And yet, you know, I found that's one of the most creative thoughts I ever thought in my life. What is your state of mind when you contemplate the possibility of everything becoming nothing? All right, so the universe is a transitory system, like a bubble, like smoke, like foam on the water. And so, how easy? Just go along with it. Dissolve. So, what's the problem? Why don't we want to give up? What do we think we're going to get by holding on and by resisting the dissolution? What I'm interested in for you to feel is what do you really feel like inside at the prospect of there being nothing, of this whole thing being a bubble that dissolves?
There is always a curious tie at some point between the fall and the creation. Taking this ghastly risk is the condition of there being life. You see, for all, the life is an act of faith and an act of gamble. The moment you enter any kind of relationship, what an act of faith. You've given yourself up. But this is the most powerful thing that could be done. Surrender. See, and love is an act of surrender to another person.
You see, about death, the reality of approaching death, people are apt to feel chilly, cold, lonely, scared, because it's an unknown. The most frightening thing about death is there might be something beyond it, and you don't know what it is.
Of course, everybody wishes to hold forever to the memories and to the people and the situations that he particularly loves. But surely, if we think this through, is that what we actually want? Do we really want to have those we love, however greatly we love them, for always and always and always and always? Isn't it inconceivable that even in a very distant future, we wouldn't get tired of it?
And there comes a point when you have to say, I'm sorry, but I am completely going to abandon responsibility for anything. And then the curious thing that occurs is the moment all that is dropped, suddenly it dawns on you that to be important, existence does not have to go on any longer than a moment. It follows from that, you see, that if any one of us, without being shocked into it by being bombed or put in a concentration camp, could at this moment be as one about to die, genuinely and honestly, we would understand the mystery of life.